murderer. We found a revolver underneath the lumberyard window. I don't know where it came from.
Nina finds it. Going here. Aha! We're getting somewhere. Guns. Whitworth rifle. The first sniper rifle has an astonishing accuracy. This particular one smells as though it's been fired within the past few hours. Also, a regimental insignia is carved into the stock. 11th Regiment of Foot, Gold Coast.
I should go back and ask about this.
Definitely the murder weapon. Which is more likely the shot. I'd say it's probably the... in the shopkeeper's possession. Guess this DLC episode actually feature makes the gamer, myself, think critically than I would actually expect. Let's go see the shopkeeper once more. Out the way, man.
Admit it. Our self-stolen rifles and pistols. All very hush-hush. Black market. I made that shot. Early this morning, Prescott challenged me to plug the 12 from my shot. I missed just slow. No one witnessed it. It was too early in the morning.
Yeah. Well, I brought that gun back from Africa. I was a sniper fighting the Ashanti. I used that gun this morning for Prescott's challenge. It's the only Whitworth we have. I'd never sell it.
Go meet with Aberline. Go meet with Freddy Aberline. The gun wasn't at the crime. Which obviously means that the gun was taken, hidden, and stashed. Thank you. Hexagonal barrel. Hexagon. So this gun is obviously the murder weapon.
I made that shot. Early this morning, Prescott challenged me to plug the 12 from my shot. I missed just slow. No one witnessed it. It was too early in the morning.
I'm stumped and I've gone over everything.
I believe I should re-interrogate a suspect. Oh.
Yeah. Well, Prescott led a flanking sortie that went wrong. Lots of casualties. Some men called the colonel a coward, but it were really just bad luck. Anyway, he resigned. To make amends, he offered work at his factory whenever one of us left the army. I brought that gun back from Africa. I was a sniper fighting the Ashanti. I used that gun this morning for Prescott's challenge. It's the only Whitworth we have. I'd never sell it.
I made that shot. Early this morning, Prescott challenged me to plug the 12 from my shot. I missed just slow. No one witnessed it. It was too early in the morning.
Yeah. Well.
I was on my way here. Heard two shots I did, right at the stroke of noon. Bullet hole in the clock. That's a new one. It could have already been there when I arrived at noon. Or maybe it was the second shot I heard. Prescott put that up in memory of the time he led a sortie across the Frye River to outflank Ashanti warriors. Things turned out badly that day. Horrific. We lost several of our comrades. Prescott wanted us to remember them.
Revolver underneath the lumberyard window. Don't know where it came from. We stood right there on a mark and shot the target. I went to...
Thank you.
I should go back and ask about this.
Prescott put that up in memory of the time he led a sortie across the Prah River to outflank Ashanti warriors. Things turned out badly that day. Horrific. We lost several of our comrades. Prescott wanted us to remember them.
Be right back. Okay, I'm back. I'm back with Let's Play Classic between Assassin's Creed Syndicate, the Dreadful Crimes DLC Episode 2. Now, at the top of this stream, I was trying to investigate the death of the Colonel. Now, it was an intentional firearms discharge mixed in with an accidental firearm discharge. We found the murder weapon. We just had to put it all together, and where do I go from here? So let's continue, shall we? I'd examined the clues, I examined the persons of interest, but somehow I'm baffled. I've examined the attic, the courtyard, the shop, and the munitions factory. So let's examine the body again. Lewis Prescott, killed by a single bullet that entered his chest, passed directly through his heart, and exited from his back. Already looked at the trajectory. There's the blood splatter from the shot, which identifies as his blood. But here, feather.
I didn't ask about this.
And then there was this clock. One gunshot hit the clock, which I'm assuming was some street kids were playing with a pistol, using it for target practice, and it fired through the target.
I didn't ask about this.
And they surmised that the bullet didn't hit the colonel or hit anybody except for maybe that clock. And then here, a bullet hole. It was a hexagonal bullet that came from a hexagonal barrel, which we identified as the Whitworth rifle. So it's obviously the kids are in the clear because the kids had a pistol and they didn't have the rifle in question. So it definitely factors them out, or rules them out of it. So this is Jonas Hassett.
I was on my way here. Heard two shots, I did.
So he's definitely telling the truth, as far as I know. But I'm still gonna need something else.
Now that I've
examined
seen this,
all the clues,
I should
and
ask
everything.
More questions.
So I'm gonna have to go around the whole area. What we got here? Puddle of spilled beer, not circumstantial, but it's not necessary evidence.
Draw your weapons and fire!
Oh, I see something, maybe. Look at the guy running into a barricade. Over this entire area.
Thank you.
need an hand?
Looking like a good old gang battle.
All right, there, Mr. Frye.
Yeah. Run your pockets.
Watch out!
That is a door nail. And good riddance.
Bullet trail came from here. Wait, wait. I'm one to think that this guy... However, the shopkeeper who was... Shopkeeper might have. I think it's the shopkeeper because the book came out of this window, which means he took a shot at the guy. So we got some. One thing I probably did not look at. Weapon wasn't found at the crime scene except at, in upstairs at the shop. Thinking it's this guy. Because I can see the trajectory. You look at it, see? From here. I think this guy.
I made that shot. Early this morning, Prescott challenged me to plug the 12 from our shop. I missed just slow. No one witnessed it. It was too early in the morning.
Am I ready to accuse? I am scout. Good luck. Was Worms. He hid the gun upstairs, so it was definitely, I'm one to think it was him. But when can I start accusing him?
When Colonel Prescott retired from the army, he used his connections and started this munitions factory. He wanted the men that served with him to have work when they left the army. The young lads across the street were fooling with a pistol they'd found. A bullet must have gone astray through the wooden fence, hit Mr. Prescott smack in the chest. Bloody unlucky for all concerned. Apparently, they put the clock there while doing some repairs. It still runs, I notice.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
It's the park bench. Look. No impact.
I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect. Indicates that bullet exited the courtyard.
We gotta find their gun. Lumberyard window. Don't know where it came from. We stood right there on a mark and shot the target.
Lumberyard window. Thank you. gigantic thing.
When Colonel Prescott retired from the army, he used his connections and started this munitions factory.
Well now, I didn't ask about this.
There are three shots. That means getting light of fire.
I made that shot. Early this morning, Prescott challenged me to plug the...
Be right back. So I'm at the last hour of this stream of Assassin's Creed Syndicate, The Dreadful Crimes, Episode 2, and I'm just about to crack the case of Death Stalks the Colonel. Here we go. There's some more territory I have not covered. So I'm just going to walk a little further. Right where those two bobbies were, the two patrolmen. Need to go further that way. I think that was leading on to a clue. That's why they wouldn't die. Past the barricades. Let's crack this case. Funk-ass controller. Okay. All right, here we go. The barrel depot. What the hell? Around here.
I'm in big trouble.
Fire!
Finish him off. Go for a drink.
Bye bye, asshole.
Mr. Frye, good to see you again, sir.
Go on, play in proper.
Serves you bloody well right.
Butts in the air. Barrel depot, empty barrel. There is a round hole through one of the barrel panels. Inside is a spent bullet. The caliber of the bullet matches the orphan's revolver. Okay. The orphan obviously wasn't the shooter, as I've said before. There's a few more clues I need to touch over. Oh wait. Something here. Inspect. Medicine. Treatment for trypanosomiasis. I think that's the closest thing I'm going to get with that. Trypanosomiasis, a disease transmitted by tsetse flies in Africa.
I should return and find
like
out
malaria.
About this.
No, it's like malaria, I think. Trypanosomiasis. Trypanosomiasis. Okay. Trypanosomiasis.
Well,
say that five times.
I didn't ask about this.
I dare you. Stepping over here. Oh wait, there's a bag. The flock bears the insignia of the 11th Regiment of Foot. It's a backpack. Gonna... Looks like some kind of a spatter. Oh wait, it's a dead bird. A partially plucked dead white goose. Dead goose. I got 4 clues found and 2 POIs to interview in this area. Persons of interest. Bennett.
Saw him each morning as I drove by. Seemed like a good sort. We lost an entire barrel of beer, damn it. I heard 2 loud bangs, but thought nothing of it. Later, I found a bullet hole in a barrel. Imagine that, a bullet hole. My lad Samuel might know more. He's around Samuel. Back, tossing trash in the river.
All right. By the way, what do you know about Samuel?
The poor lad. Fell on my doorstep a few years ago. He's in a bad way, has some sort of malady. Rides in the back while I make deliveries. Hard worker, very determined.
Yeah, that's probably his medication for trypanosomiasis.
I just drop off beer. Don't pay much attention to people along the way.
He's a little shaky. I don't know.
There was an hole in a barrel. I've got no explanation for that.
Not forthcoming with information, that's why.
That's for some sickness I picked up a while ago. Can't remember the name of it.
Trypanosomiasis. Probably like maybe it's right up there with malaria. That's my guess. Okay, you have everything needed to solve the mystery. Make an accusation. This is gonna be a tough one. He doesn't remember the medication he took.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
Triple summarized. Now I gotta accuse somebody. Factor in all the stuff he can't accuse him. Definitely look harder at the entity. Anyone that has a motor.
The poor lad. Fell on my doorstep a few years ago. He's in a bad way. Has some sort of
So it's definitely not these guys.
Feed you to me dogs. I don't want to die. And I'm in please now.
Now I gotta make an accusation. I wanna make a sound accusation, otherwise my reward money goes down.
Who's a good boss? You are. Doing fine, girl.
Boy's not the person, so...
That a girl?
Whoa, now!
On your orders!
Walk on, girl.
Let's go.
So the cops won't die. Gonna meet with Freddy Armour.
The young lads across the street were fooling with a pistol they found. A bullet must have gone...
Okay. I'm gonna make my accusation. I could be wrong, but I think all roles point to Curtis. I'm about to accuse Curtis. I don't know anybody else. Check out the history.
I made that shot. Early this morning, Prescott challenged me to plug the 12 from my shot. I missed just slow. No one witnessed it. It was too early in the morning.
I think he accidentally shot him.
Yeah. Well, Prescott led a flanking sortie that went wrong. Lots of casualties. Some men called the colonel a coward, but it were really just bad luck. Anyway, he resigned. To make amends, he offered work at his factory whenever one of us left the army.
Well, I could be wrong, but I'm about to accuse him.
Me? I couldn't have shot him from the attic at that angle. I only shot a clock.
Wrong accusation. There goes the roaring man. I was wrong. It wasn't him. When they confess, you know you got the right person. I need to determine that. It might be the other guy.
I was here all along. The gun went off over there somewheres. We're not in Africa anymore. The war's over for us. I don't...
Big deal, the war money goes down. It was gonna be that one other guy. And it wasn't Freddy Avalon either. So it's that other guy. Are often those that have something to hide. Military experience is another thing. He doesn't know much about it. Maybe he'll try it.
His goddamn cowardice in Africa got me best friends killed.
Aha.
I should have faced a firing squad.
Got him. I should have used him. Oh.
Very good sleuthing on your part. It's a miracle anyone survived what with all those bullets whizzing about.
Okay, let's read this, shall we? Death stalks the colonel. His friends die in a bungled military maneuver and vows revenge, slowed by an army sharpshooter watches his friends die in a bungled military maneuver and vows revenge, slowed by a tropical disease contracted on the Gold Coast. Private Samuel Frye spent years planning his vengeance on Lewis Prescott, the colonel whose cowardice meant death for his companion. He taunted Prescott with the symbolic white feather, and then, at the stroke of noon, took his final revenge. Many bullets flew that day. A bullet from the shop attic lodged in Prescott's factory clock. A bullet from the revolver found by some children lodged in a passing beer cart. And the bullet fired by Samuel in the back of that car struck Prescott directly in the heart. Henry Raymond. Looks like the reward money didn't go down that much. Looks like the reward money did not go down that much, but either way. No, I gotta do my stuff. Hello?
Feed you to me dogs.
So let's look and see where we are. Okay. Any more dreadful crime? Okay, in this area. To get a preview. This one is called The Mystery of the Twice Dead Professor. Reward £2,000. Gonna do a quick trap. Oh wait, there's another. Locked in to die. Brass. £2,000. Okay. Closer. We'll do this one, but quick. Travel. So I'm in the last half hour of this stream of Assassin's Creed Syndicate, Dreadful Crime. Finally just solved the case, but I accused two POIs. But the reward money didn't go down so much, so I'm excited about that. But now, let's go to the next location for the next case, which is hop, skip, and a jump from here. It's entitled, what's it again? Locked In to Die. Okay. I'm actually enjoying this DLC. It actually challenges me. I mean, it's a little bit like L.A. Noir, but not completely. I think I'm gonna switch as Evie. Have a little feminine touch.
My turn.
Up ya! Come on!
That's a good girl.
Easy, girl. Easy now.
Get in, troops. We gotta case this all.
Come on.
I always like traveling with a full gang. Always. Because you can have up to 5 gang members. You start off with about probably 2 or 3. And then full strength 5. Reminds me of the Warriors video game. In case you didn't know, Rockstar Games made the Warriors into a video game back in 2005. If you know, you know.
Warriors, come out to play. Warriors, come out to play.
Locked in to die. Let's get the freedom. Saw the perplexing locked room murder.
My write-up of that last crime was so ingenious that Purlock Publishing tossed me quite a tidy sum. I believe this next one will do even better.
It's baffling. The room was locked. How did the murderer get in and out?
Inspect Byron Cashan's body. Let's find the body.
Shoot now!
I'm the bug. Thank you. Smoke him. Thank you. Smoke him.
Someone's kicked the bucket.
A
I know the poor beggar?
You ain't gonna report shit.
Good riddance to bag rubbish.
That is a doornail. A good riddance.
The body's inside. Sorry. We gotta find out what the cause of death is as well. As well as who did it and the motive. That's all I need, pretty much. Over Cashin's body. Cashin's body. No signs of a struggle. No wounds. So how do you kill somebody? I mean, he either was probably poisoned, and then he ends up being dead. Let's talk to the maid.
I'm just the housekeeper, but Mr. Cashin was a dear friend. Each morning I bring him his coffee. Today his door was locked shut. My husband is the caretaker. We live downstairs. We have the keys to all the apartments, so after knocking, I became concerned and let myself in and found him like this. The lights weren't working. My husband didn't want to waste any candles, so we retired early.
Standard door with lock and hinges in normal state. Oh, there's something on there's a paper.
Stop this, get up. You just made more work for me, you blind idiot. Because I have all the time in the world to mend what Pillock's cock up.
Cashin's room. Review. Public review. Published review of a recent concert. The latest effort by Aldwych Chamber Orchestra must be counted as a fiasco. Let me read this as a dramatic, stereotypical Brit from back in the day. Here we go.
Because I have all the time in the world to mend what Pillock's cock up.
Published review of a recent concert. The latest effort by the Aldwych Chamber Orchestra must be counted as a fiasco. The woodwinds were discordant and cacophonous. Rather than playing Mendelssohn, the strings fought with him. In particular, the solo performed by the first violin was a disaster. This gentleman is better equipped to perform in the London sewers. I would advise anyone who has contemplated attending to instead remain quietly at home. Byron Cashin. I guess someone hated that review. Air vent communicating with the neighbor's apartment. Next door. Oh, more evidence opened up. Oh, here we go. Kashan's room. Editor letter. Letter from Kashan's editor. Byron, you old rogue. Your evisceration of the Outwitch group was delicious. Our readers can't get enough of your clever and delightfully unkind reviews. All the ensembles in town live in fear. Keep up the good work. You must have a fan. Candles. Yellowed candles that have burned down the nub. Burned down to the nub. That dialogue is getting very repetitive and annoying. Ooh, a key. Labeled basement. Basement key. Okay. I think he was killed on account of an angry review. Bloomfield's room. Newspaper. Several articles. One about the Queen's plan to use the storied scepter with a dub to the knight and industrialists. Let me read that again. Several articles. One about the Queen's plans to use the storied scepter with the dub to knight and an industrialist. Another about the publishing business. A third concerning the Outwitch Chamber Orchestra, which has disbanded for lack of funds. Oh, now we're getting somewhere. A series of damning reviews by London's most influential critic has... Let me read as it. A series of damning reviews by London's most influential critic has crushed all hope of attracting an audience. Sheet music. Andante for violin and piano in D minor by Felix Mendelssohn.
I should go back and ask about this.
So I think the disgruntled musicians. Candelabra, a candelabra of partially burned white candle.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this. I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect.
Here we have Mrs. Bloomfield, neighbor to the victim. Let's talk, sister.
Mr. Cashin is dead? I just saw him yesterday. He looked in the peak of health. If you ask me, he paid a bit too much attention to the caretaker's wife. Scandalous, really. They must have seen each other nearly every day.
Oh, something else.
When the lights quit working yesterday,
an affair of the heart.
Sweet Mr. Golden handed out candles to everyone. He's such a nice man. Last night, I was knitting in that chair. Then I felt quite sickly and opened the window to clear my head. I certainly didn't hear anything.
Okay, how about you? Have you anything to say, Mr. Bloomfield?
Gone just like that, eh? He lived right next door. Gone just like that, eh? He lived right next door and often came home from his concerts a bit drunk and singing at the top of his lungs. Drove my wife near crazy. I was down in the cellar, fiddling with my experiments.
Sheet music?
That belongs to Mr. Golden. He's an awfully nice chap. We let him use our apartment during the day when my wife and I are out tending our shop. He likes to rehearse here where the light's better.
Golden, we definitely need to talk to that guy.
I'm an amateur chemist.
Henman let me set musician. Up a few experiments
he's
in the cellar.
And probably part of that band that he wrote that not-so-colorful review of, and as a result can't get work.
I'm an amateur chemist. Henman let me set up a few experiments Henman. In the cellar.
Got some more people to interview. You.
The lights weren't working. My husband didn't want to waste any candles, so we retired early.
Mrs. Henn.
It's true. I loved him. He was the best thing that ever happened to me.
What, I accused her? I don't think so.
The lights weren't working. My husband didn't want to waste any.
Nope. Definitely, because I still need to get all the evidence, get everything I need. Wire fabrication. By the way, it's almost another stream. So let's interview the people downstairs. I thought I'd just accuse her out of the bright, clear blue sky, but no. I need to factor in all the evidence and all the POIs before I make the accusation. What we got here? Mr. Henman, caretaker. Sooty clothes. Golden's room. Sheet music. String quartet number 6 in F minor. Op 80. Violin concerto in E minor. Op 64. Sonata for violin and piano in F minor. Op 4. Some sheet music. Box of white candles almost all gone.
I should go back and ask about this.
Gave out candles, according to the testimony of Mrs. Bloomfield. Shavings, white shavings on the floor appear to be wax. So maybe he was burned in his room. One little thing I need to look at when I touch it. I ain't talking to you yet. Says here, violin string box. Violin strings along with tools for precise trimming of the string. So it's...
I work very late. So did he. I only met him once or twice in the 2 years I've been living here. I was out giving a benefit recital for unemployed musicians. Several dozen people can attest to my whereabouts.
Okay. How about the box?
I use them to create an ambience when I hold private recitals.
Yeah, but I think he might have been part of that musician band. Might have been part of the band that can't get work because of the damning review. Clothing. Men's clothes. Very dirty with soot. Okay. Sooty clothes. Let's factor that in. But the body had no evidence of how the victim was killed. Had no wounds. Let's check here. The lab. The basement lab. Chemistry experiment. Oh, he might have been... Oh, yeah, through the vent, so... He must have been gassed through the vents. Beakers, funnels, a mortar, and pesto and various chemical compounds. I think Bloomfield or somebody. Somebody done it. Look at here. Gas tank. A coal gas tank that supplies gas to all the rooms in the building, covered in dirt and soot.
I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect.
So Golden, or might have been at least two people responsible for that. Talk to Henry.
Mr. Cashin's dead. Difficult to believe. He led a quiet life. Out at concerts most nights, shut up in his room writing the rest of the time. He must have been a lonely man. My wife felt sorry for him and helped him as often as she could. I'm in charge of the running and upkeep of the whole building, so I can get dirty now and then. I was just doing some work in the basement.
There's some more clues I need to look at. Key holder. Keys to all the apartments as well as the basement. The basement key was left in the Bloomer, within Bloomfield, in the Bloomfield's room. I think Bloomfield had something to do with it. Candle lab run. Gas lamp. Common lighting fixture. The light won't turn on. Okay, there's something else here. Chemical, a small beaker of a yellow fluid, liquid half full.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
So the victim was gassed and locked in his room. So the maid did not do it. Oh wait, yeah, the maid definitely did not. Someone maybe close to the maid, like maybe a husband. That guy might have done it, but it has to be somebody who's making experiments, or somebody who stole the experiment. That's some more clues. I get them all. I'm about to get ready to end this screen. And that's going to do it for this edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Assassin's Creed Syndicate, The Dreadful Crimes, Episode 2. I will continue this on a later day. Until then, I'm Killed the Vid for the 9 to 5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, and please stay safe.